Racing to the 2023 Belmont Stakes, and let's get an update for the final day in May. And on the big board, we've got Reincarnate passing on the Belmont Stakes. Angel of Empire, we're going to take a look at the Kentucky Derby runners, their trips in that race, and how they got those trips. And the Festival of Racing fields are starting to firm up as we get closer, just 10 days away from the Belmont Stakes 2023. On Tuesday, it was announced that Reincarnate will be passing on the Belmont Stakes. Of course, he had just had the one workout post Kentucky Derby. He is more of a speed horse that puts a little bit less speed in the race. Reincarnate going to take some time off and then start to point for the Midsummer Derby. He's going to see if he can paint that canoe at Saratoga. The Belmont field still sitting at about 10 confirmed runners. We've still got two runners on the fence, Archangelo, the Peter Pan winner, Arabian Lion, the Sir Barton winner, but we do have four horses from the Kentucky Derby in Hit Show. We've also got Angel of Empire, Raise Kane, and Tapit Trice, the Preakness winner, National Treasure, and the Juvenile Champion in Forte. Let's take a look at the trips of Angel of Empire in the Kentucky Derby. Kind of interesting to take a look at the winner of that race, Mage, compare him to Tapit Trice and Angel of Empire, because I think they're both going to receive a lot of support at the windows in the Belmont Stake. Angel of Empire, the Arkansas Derby winner, he won the Risen Star. He was third in the Kentucky Derby. He did go off the favorite in the Kentucky Derby, but that was after some of the late scratches and it was reduced to an 18-horse field. Originally, he was 8-1 on the morning line for the Kentucky Derby. Now, the start of the Kentucky Derby was a pretty even start this year, and I wanted to show the freeze frame on the start. Hit Show out of the one post position got a beautiful start, no trip troubles, probably the first horse in 5 or 6 years that has not had any trip trouble. There's some separation between him and the two. He came out straight, so Hit Show got a perfect start. Angel of Empire is number 14. Derma Sotagaki is to his outside. He had a little bit of a troubled start, and then Sun Thunder was to his inside, so a perfect start for Angel of Empire. Tapit Trice, the five horse, broke just a step slow, but nobody was in his way, so really a clear start to the race for Angel of Empire in the Kentucky Derby, along with Mage. Now, a quarter of a mile into the race, this is where you start to see the runners, where the big field starts to hamper some of the closers. Hit Show at the rail, the one horse, again, saving ground, only one horse to his outside, getting a good trip. Now, Mage was ahead of Angel of Empire after a quarter of a mile. He is the eight horse in blue. The lighter blue, I got him highlighted in gold here. Then Angel of Empire in the darker blue, he is right behind Mage, but further outside of him. And then Tapit Trice actually trails the field. He is giving up both ground and Sun Thunder to his outside, and he's given up position to both Mage and Angel of Empire, despite starting with a better post. Now, when you get to the 6 furlong mark, we've got that fast pace. Angel of Empire in the blue, he had to wait. He's trapped a little bit inside horses. Perfect ride up from Javier Castellano. Mage is totally in the clear. He is able to get first run, and that's really how it plays out at that 6 furlong mark, with Angel of Empire getting that move. Now, Angel of Empire saved ground early on. Then he had to wait. Mage had clear run. Let's watch the video of this, how it plays out. Mage gets first run. Angel of Empire has to swing out to the outside. Tapit Trice doesn't get, he has to go outside in the stretch run, loses ground in that race. And that's really where the race was run. Mage getting a clear run, Angel of Empire having to wait on that turn, but still a clear trip. So that is a look at those three runners from the Kentucky Derby. I really think Angel of Empire is going to run a big race in the Belmont. I don't see any distance limitations. Tapit Trice is going to run a big race in the Belmont, but he is going to start slow again. He's going to have to pass the entire field again in the Belmont Stakes, but now he gets an extra quarter of a mile to do it. The Jaipur, a grade one on the turf, that is going to be part of the Belmont Racing Festival. And it did gain a big runner on Tuesday, Caravelle. is going to pass on Royal Ascot, going to point to the Jaipur. He's going to be taking on Big Invasion, Front Red in the Fed, a big stakes runner the last time, Arrest Me Red, and Casa Creed, the 2022 winner of the Jaipur Stakes. Caravelle, no Ascot for him. Here he is, the last time out, a win at Churchill Downs. Of course, he won the big Breeders' Cup at a big price. He's got 22 starts, 14 wins, 4 wins in a row for Caravelle. Going to be part of the Belmont Stakes Festival of Racing. The True North picked up a strong runner, Elite Power. Not going to run on the Met Mile. Going to be taking on Strobe and Dr. Shivel, a recent winner out west. Of course, Elite Power, the Breeders' Cup Sprint winner. He won the Saudi Sprint this year. He won at Saratoga. Here he is winning at Saratoga. Explosive stretch run, wearing those Judmont colors on the outside. 9 starts, 6 wins, 6 wins in a row for Elite Power. He is going to that True North Stakes on the Friday of the Belmont Stakes. The Met Mile, going to get Cody's Wish. White Abario worked out on Tuesday. Doppelganger, of course, he's won back-to-back races after moving from the West Coast to the East Coast. Slow Down Andy, a strong miler. He ran in the Breeders' Cup Dirt Mile. Smile Happy, still considering the race. He won the Ali Sheba at 1/16. That would be a cutback at 1 mile to him. Smile Happy, one of the favorites in the Kentucky Derby last year. A lightly raced horse, still some room to improve. And then you've got Taba, the Malibu Stakes winner for Bob Baffert. Of course, he ran 1 race this year, and 1 mile could be a good spot for Taba to get back on the winning end. So a strong race in the Jaipur, strong race in the Met Mile. Those are both grade ones. We've got the Woody Stevens. You got General Jim, the winner of the Pat Day Mile. Fort Bragg, the pace setter in the Florida Derby. Gilmore, also a big stakes contester this year. And then Fort Warren, a recent winner at Pimlico. He's by Curlin, but he could definitely be a strong 7 furlong type horse, as the Woody Stevens is 7 furlongs on the dirt on all part of that Saturday on the Belmont Stakes. Of course, you've got the Just a Game, the Intercontinental, and the New York Stakes race on the turf. Of course, the Belmont Racing Festival, June 8th through June 10th. Belmont Stakes Day is June 10th. So the field's starting to shape up. Don't forget, I did my Elite 8 video. If you want to watch that on Tuesday, Tapit, Trice, Angel of Empire, Hit Show, National Treasure, Red Route 1. Archangelo, if he goes to the race, I think he's a contender. Forte came out of his work good. It looks like he's going to have one more work to get ready. And I think Forte will be the favorite in the Belmont Stakes. So the trip notes, Angel of Empire, I think he had a little bit of a trip trouble. I think Mage had a better trip in the Derby. And I think Tapit Trice is going to have to come from the rear of the pack again in the Belmont Stakes. So as we start to look at these fields, we'll take a look at some more of these runners and their trip notes as they get ready for the Belmont Festival of Racing. As Dwayne Lucas says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.